friends, today I am going to present a short tutorial on cardiac output. Now first let us understand here what do you mean by cardiac output. The cardiac output is the amount of the blood pumped or ejected by each ventricle per minute. The stroke volume is the amount of blood pumped by each ventricle per beat or per contraction. Hence cardiac output can be calculated by multiplying stroke volume by the heart as shown here. Now let us assume that the heart rate is 70 beats per minute and stroke volume is 80 ml. Thus cardiac output will be 80 multiplied by 70, and that will come as 0.56 liters per minute. Normal range is in between 5 to 6 liters per minute. We can even determine that the cardiac index as cardiac output divided by body surface area. Now in this case we have taken this value 5.6 divided by body surface area 1.7 square meter, and that comes as 3.2 liters per minute per square meter. Similarly, we can determine here stroke volume divided by body surface area. 80 divided by 1.7 is equal to, that is 47 ml per beat per square meter. Now there are some of the factors which affect the cardiac output. The first is the venous return. If more is the venous return, or more venous return increases cardiac output and vice versa. Venous return depends on the contraction of the skeletal muscle. Respiration, as we know that inspiration increases cardiac output. Pressure between capillaries and the venules. Sympathetic stimulation increases heart rate. Force of contraction also affects the cardiac output. Adequate supply and oxygen and nutrients, that will also affect cardiac output. Heart rate, moderate increase in the heart rate causes moderate increase in the cardiac output or maintains normal cardiac output. The peripheral resistance also affects the cardiac output. More is the peripheral resistance, lesser will be the cardiac output. Hence, we can determine here cardiac output is equal to arterial blood pressure divided by peripheral resistance. Now, this figure shows here that is the cardiac index in the adult man, adult woman, children, and that is the say children of different ages, 9 years, 10 years, in the range of 12 to 13, and you can see the variation in the say the cardiac index as shown in the figure. So which are the physiological factors which affect the cardiac output? First is the age. Children have less body surface area, hence more cardiac index than adults. Sex. Body surface area is less in the females, hence they have more cardiac index than the males. Diurnal variation. In the early morning, cardiac output is low, which increases in the daytime depending upon the basal condition of the individual. Environmental temperature. A high environmental temperature is associated with increase in the cardiac output. Anxiety and the environment are reported to increase in say cardiac output, say approximately by 30%. Exercise also affects the cardiac output. It may increase the cardiac output up to 70% depending upon the vigorousness of exercise. Pregnancy also affects the cardiac output. An increase in the cardiac output up to 45 to 60% is reported during the latter months of pregnancy. High altitude. In the cardiac output is increased at high altitude due to release of adrenaline as consequence to hypoxia. Posture change, sitting or standing from lying down position may decrease the cardiac output by 20 to 30% because of pooling of blood in lower limbs. Emotions, excitement causes increase in the cardiac output and vice versa. Now there are some of the pathological factors which also affect the cardiac output. Now, it is observed that there is an increase in the cardiac output is observed in following condition, that is fever due to increased oxidative process, anemia due to hypoxia, hyperthyroidism due to increased metabolism. The second factor is decrease in the cardiac output may also occur in the following condition: rapid arrhythmia due to incomplete filling, congestive heart failure due to weak contractions of the heart, cardiac shock due to poor pumping and circulation, incomplete heart block due to defective pumping action of the heart, hemorrhage because of decreased blood volume. Hypothyroidism also say cause a decrease in the cardiac output due to decreased basal metabolism. Which are the methods to determine the cardiac output? These methods are broadly divided into two categories, direct method and the indirect method. In direct method, these are the all experimental methods. In animal studies, cardiac output is determined by directly placing electromagnetic flow meter on the ascending aorta. In the indirect methods, where we use, say, the all methods based on the fixed principle. Indicator are dye dilution method, thermodilution method, and method employing inhalation of the inert gas. And there are, say, physical methods such as Doppler technique echocardiography and ballistocardiography. Now, we will see some of the methods. First, what is this fixed principle? The fixed principle says that the amount of substance taken by an organ or by the whole body per unit of time is equal to the arterial level of the substance minus venous level, what we call the AV difference, times the blood flow, which is expressed as the amount of the substance taken per unit of time is equal to artery-venous difference multiplied by, that is, the blood flow. For example, amount of oxygen consumed is 250 ml per minute. Arterial blood O2 concentration is 90 ml per minute per 100 ml. Venous blood oxygen concentration is 40 ml per minute per 100 ml. Hence, amount of substance taken per unit time is equal to 250 is equal to multiplied by, say, AV difference, multiple, that is 5, and multiplied by blood flow. Now here, in this example, cardiac output will be O2 consumption per ml per minute, and that is the, say, AV difference, that is per ml, that is per minute for 100 ml. Hence, that comes as, that is, this value comes as 250 multiplied by 100 divided by 5, that comes as 500 ml per minute, that is the 5 liters per minute will be the cardiac output. The second method is dye dilution method. In dye dilution method, the cardiac output is equal to the amount of substance injected divided by its average concentration of arterial blood after single circulation through the heart. Now the dye which is used is, say, that is T1824. This dye is totally harmless, which, say, doesn't interfere with, say, the physiological functions. My idea is that, say, we inject, say, a known amount of the system and determine the substance and know and determine. In dye dilution method, what is this method? The cardiac output is equal to the amount of substance injected divided by its average concentration in arterial blood after a single circulation to the heart. The dye which is used here in this method is T1824. This dye is totally harmless. It do not, say, that is, interfere with, say, physiological function. Now let us assume that we have injected here, say, known amount of this substance, say 5 milligram of the substance is injected. Now let us say determine, that is, the average concentration in the arteriovenous blood. It is, say, 1.6 mg per ml. When the total time taken by this substance to be circulated in the body is 39 seconds. And hence, we are going to determine the flow for 39 seconds, and there we are going to convert it into, that is, the, say, 60 seconds. Hence, 5 mg divided by 1.6 means, that is, the flow in 39 seconds will be 3.1 liters per 39 seconds. We have to simply convert it into 60 seconds, and that gives us a cardiac output, 60 multiplied by 3.1 divided by 39, and that gives you value as a, that is 4.7 liters per minute, and that is nothing but the cardiac output which is determined during rest. Similarly, we can determine, say, that is the cardiac output during exercise. Now the time taken for the substance to be circulated within body is only 9 seconds. And hence, that is, the flow for 9 seconds will be 5 milligrams, and the average concentration now it will be 1.51 milligrams per ml. Mean that gives you the flow for 9 seconds is how much? 3.3 liters per 9 seconds. You have to simply convert it into the 60 seconds, and that will give the cardiac output, that is, during exercise, mean that is 60 multiplied by 3.3 divided by 9, it gives the cardiac output to 22 liters per minute. It indicates that is the cardiac output increases or it is more during exercise as compared to the rest. So we can understand this from, say, this figure, that is the time taken of this substance to be circulated during, say, rest, and that is during exercise. Now exercise, say, is shown in the green color, and rest, say, circulation is shown in the red color. Y-axis indicates the average concentration of the substance, milligrams per ml, and x-axis indicates the time taken for the circulation. Now you can observe here, say, the time taken for the substance to be circulated during rest, if you extrapolate this graph, and that will be, say, 39 seconds approximately. And during exercise, the time taken is less, and that will be approximately, say, that is the 9 seconds. In this way, we determine the cardiac output. Now we have seen here the definition part of the cardiac output. We have seen the factors affecting the cardiac output. We have seen the methods to determine the cardiac output. I will stop here. Thank you for watching.